मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, माय नेम इज़ सचिन एंड टुडे आई एम अगेन हेयर इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू विद अनदर नॉवल बाय डॉक्टर आर के नारायण। आई एम सचिन मित्तल फ्रॉम सचिन्स अकेडमी संगरूर विच इज़ इन पंजाब। सो टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग द नॉवल द गाइड। वी विल गो थ्रू द समरी ऑफ दिस नॉवल। माइंड इट, this novel was written by Dr. R. K. Narayan and he was also given the Sahitya Academy Award for this novel. So let's start with the novel. So starting with this story, The Guide, this is a story of a man named Raju who comes from a fictional village of South India, Malgudi. Born to a shopkeeper, Raju grows up at the time of great changes taking place, including the construction of railway line that comes to the town during his childhood. After his father's sudden death, Raju takes the rail station shop to continue, but he doesn't remain a shopkeeper for long. Soon, he takes to showing the visitors who arrive at the railway station the many sights of Malgudi. That is, this shopkeeper Raju now turns himself into a guide. Moving, his reputation as a guide grows to such an extent that he comes to be known as Railway Raju. Raju meets his match in Marco Polo, who is an archaeologist, and arrives in Malgudi to research the cave paintings and the temples scattered around the town, Malgudi. Marco Polo engages Raju's services as a guide, and when Raju meets his young and beautiful wife, Rosie, who arrives there shortly after her husband, Raju is immediately taken by Rosie, who, in spite of her foreign name, is an Indian woman trained in the art of Indian classical dance. Right? Moving forward, when Raju takes Rosie to visit a snake charmer and watches her as she imitates the snake's movements in a fleeting dance, he realizes that she is the greatest dancer he has ever seen. Seeking to get closer to Rosie, he devotes himself to her and her husband's care. Soon it becomes clear to him that the couple is liable to bouts of quarreling. Rosie is dissatisfied with her husband. Raju flatters and compliments her, praising her dance abilities, and soon they strike up an affair behind Marco's back. right? Moving forward, Rosie again tries to talk to her husband about commencing a career in classical dance and reveals that she is having an affair with the tourist guide Raju, who always appreciates her talent in dancing. This leads to a crisis between the couple, the husband and wife, and Raju returns to Malgudi but has a difficult time picking up his old life. One day, Rosie appears with her luggage at Raju's house, and Raju learns from her that Marco has left her. Raju's mother is a traditional woman who accepts her presence in the house for some time. Okay? Moving forward, Rosie takes to practicing dance every day in his house, but his mother, that is Raju's mother, has heard the rumors that Rosie is a married woman and is also a dancer who belongs to a lower caste. Financial troubles also escalate as Raju's creditor, a merchant from whom he buys the wholesale supplies for the railway shop, he begins pursuing Raju in the courts to pay back his debts. So now Raju was in the court. Moreover, his mother's brother appears in the house one day. He insults Raju, Rosie and his sister for keeping a married woman, Rosie, in the house. So, his mother packs up her things and departs with her brother. One day, Rosie declares that she is ready to perform publicly under the name Nalini. And so Raju sets to arrange her first public performance. From the moment of her debut, Rosie is a huge success. Nalini is asked for everywhere, and Raju's role in managing Rosie's career transforms him into a man of wealth and influence. Raju takes to hosting important visitors and hobnobbing with the politicians, bankers, and merchants, all who seek the access to Nalini through Raju. So now Raju is an influential person. Keeping Rosie to a relentless schedule of engagements and performances, Raju starts growing jealous of the artist friends that she likes to spend time with and seeks to limit her contact with them. One day, he receives an unexpected parcel in the mail. It is a book that Marco Polo, Rosie's husband, has published on his research on the cave paintings in Malgudi. Raju hides the book from Rosie. Nonetheless, the news of the publication reaches her through the newspaper, and she becomes excited when she reads about the book. Right? Not only that, Rosie quarrels with Raju when she discovers that Marco's book has been sent to them, but that Raju has hidden it with him from her. Raju also hides a letter from Marco's lawyer that concerns a box of valuable jewelry that Marco wants to release to Rosie. Instead of sharing it with Rosie, he forges her signature, hoping to acquire the box of jewelry without her knowledge. A police officer shows up with a warrant for Raju's arrest for forgery. Raju is convicted and sentenced to a 2-year imprisonment. So now Raju is sentenced to a 2 years in prison. After his release from the prison, Raju is uncertain and sits on the bank of a river near a small village. A stranger named Villain approaches him and he tells him that he is having a trouble with his younger half-sister who refuses to accept the marriage match. Raju tries to help him, and after he brings his sister to him, she accepts the match arranged for her by her brother. Velan and his family credit this success to Raju. Raju's success leads the villagers to believe in his powers as a holy man or a spiritual guide. Raju, considering that he has nowhere to go and the offerings of food brought to him by the villagers on a daily basis provide him with free nourishment, so he decides to play the role. He grows his beard, takes up the residence in the temple by the river to play the role of the holy man. Each day congregation of villagers arrive to listen to him discourse on various topics. Right? So now Raju has been changed into a holy man. Once it so happened that a severe drought afflicts the village, and Raju is unwittingly drawn to the undertaking to a 2 weeks fast on behalf of the villagers to bring about the rains. Realizing the enormity of the sacrifice that the villagers expect him to undertake, and afraid for himself, Raju finally discloses his full life story to Velan, including his history of deceit and imprisonment. Raju hopes that Velan will see that he is an ordinary man, devoid of the powers which the villagers have invested him with. After hearing Raju, Velan's view remains unchanged. Astonished but also moved, Raju decides to undertake the fast as a way of repaying the villagers' faith in him. News of Swami's fast spreads far and wide. People come to the village by the thousands to meet the heroic holy man. And the journalists and the news people arrive to report on the developments. On the final day of the fast, Raju is so weak that he is unable to descend to the river on his own. So, with Velan's help, he musters the energy to reach the depleted river. On the brink of unconsciousness, he looks to the horizon and tells Velan that he feels rain coming over the hills. Now, this is the story of this novel, The Guide. I hope you like this story. So it's nice talking to you and narrating you the summary of this novel by R.K. Narayan. I hope you like the story. I hope you like the narration as well. Please like and share the video. Thanks for watching and giving me the time. We will meet soon. So it's goodbye from my side. Take care of yourself.